considered as a contamination of the previous one. And I will speak about the so-called Sigma Brothers monster. It's an other kind of attractors for trajectories of the dynamical systems, which can be considered along with the omega limit sets. And the start is a list of publications on this problem. And such kind of studies was started from the notion of the center of the dynamical system, which was released by him in 1936. And studied the existence of invariant dynamical systems by Krylov and Kozlov. Since many important scientists this problem. We see new systems in the in the 60s. And there are some problems which was talked about in the previous lecture. We consider sigma trackers of the dynamical system. If we have to account the statistical behavior of the touch pressure, we can consider its sigma limits instead of omega limits. It's a so-called statistical limit set of the trajectory. It's the smallest closed set such that it means all the trajectory tends to 1 for any neighborhood of this set. This is the smallest closed set. For omega limit set, we have a similar property but other one. It's a intensity for any neighborhood of omega limit set. The trajectory flows into this neighborhood after some time n for all points starting from some n. But this is trajectory can reach the neighborhood, but almost all time it is in the neighborhood. Statistically, this is statistically limited. It's easy to prove that this sigma limit set of is a subset of omega limit set. This is proved, for example, in the book by Nitzschwitz and then in many cases we can have a sigma limit set is not critical. For definitions, but in the case of similar objects, in the case of the center of the dynamical system, we can mention papers by Hirni, then Krylov and Bogolyubov. As for omega limit set, we say that the closed invariant set A is a sigma attractor if there is a point x from the space such that C sigma limit set is equal to A. For the questions, we have the following definition. We can formulate the main properties of the dynamics of the sigma attractors. And for this, we should use the notion of sigma recurrence. We say that the point x is a sigma recurrent if this point belongs to its sigma limit set. For sigma attractors, like the incompressibility property for omega limit set, we have the following property. Any sigma attractor contains a dense subset of sigma recurrent points. From this property, we can derive other properties of sigma limit sets and sigma attractors. And this can be proved in a way that was suggested by Krylov and Bogolyubov in their paper for the center of the dynamical system. Immediate proofs can be found in my paper of 1991. And this property can be derived also from general consideration for dynamical systems. It's known that every ergodic mean measure is generated by the generated points. It's a point that has the least of point masses along the orbit, and it doesn't matter. With respect to the topology of the deep convergence. This fact can be found proved in the book of Fersenberg. And having this, we now can use the fact that any invariant measure is the integral mean of all equations. The main property of sigma limit set in any sigma limit set is a dense subset of sigma limit points. It implies the following properties of the dynamics on sigma limit sets. Unlike the omega limit set, we have the following. If a sigma limit set of a point of a trajectory has an isolated point, then this point is periodic. If omega limit set is infinite, then the corresponding sigma limit set is contained in the set of limit points of omega of x. If we have the situation that a sigma limit set is not equal to omega limit set, then sigma limit set is nowhere dense in this space. If a sigma limit set contains an open set, then the trajectory of x hits this sigma limit set eventually, and we have the equality of sigma limit set and omega limit set. If omega limit set is equal sigma limit set and omega limit set is infinite, then both these sets are perfect. And this means they have no isolated points. In particular, we have a sigma of x is perfect if x is sigma regular. The sigma regular is x belongs to the sigma limit set. This property implies that sigma attractors can be decomposable into smaller invariant subsets that can be considered as dynamically independent internal components tied with an external trajectory, unlike the omega limit set, which cannot be decomposed in such a way. In order to understand this exactly, we consider some examples. Consider standard 10 to my and for this map, you can consider a homoclinic, so-called homoclinic trajectory. We have a point x from this interval for which we have omega of x is equal to the set gamma. The union of the points of this homoclinic trajectory. In this set, which consists of a countable set of points, number of points, we have this point is not isolated in the set, it's this set gamma, this the union of these points. And the other points are isolated in this gamma. So we, from the properties of the of sigma limit set, we can conclude that for this trajectory, we have the sigma limit set is only one fixed point. If we consider other,
another
omega limit set, which is the union of two heteroclinic trajectories. If we take a picture, it's easy to understand this. Well, suppose that in a compact metric space we have a continuous map and some set S is equal to sigma limit set for some point in this space. We can consider a set of isolated points of S and define the following objects in this map, in this set of S. And I start with R, which is my picture is R. For example, we let it is a plane, and we consider for example, if R is interval. Q, for example, can be a sequence of points that approach this interval at some point, for example, or some part we consider at some point. For example, this step. And this is a point that should be approached by isolated points. Point and so on. And this path should be approached by isolated points too. Well, I don't know how. Take an image. And so on. And this part of the set should be approached by not isolated part, but by its perfect part. For example, some kind of a sign approach. So, this is the isolated part of the set. This is this point A, the border of the isolated part. The GPS. And we have the set T. Now this is R. In this case, and we have to consider the intersection of R and U. This is U. And U is the border minus the part that can be approached by a perfect part. Well, this is Q. Well, if we consider closure of this point, this set, and intersected with R, we obtain in this case just one point. It's possible to construct such kind of sets more complicated, but the main properties suppose such kind of set is a sigma limit set for some point X in the space. from main property of sigma limit sets, we must have these points, all the related points should be pending. And for the border, we should have the invariance of the set. This is the border. So this is a Q and R. No, please. For the better part, we should have invariance too. And and this implies that the set R should be translated by the map into itself, and the set Q should be expanded. For the border of the isolated cells, we have a chain recurrency on this border. And if the set T is not empty, then the set T should contain an empty subset for which we have a proper invariance. In our case, we have only just one point, and for this point, we should have this point should be a fixed point for graph. And this implies some kind of dynamical restrictions on sigma limit sets. If a set is a sigma limit set on in a compact matrix space, then then every continuous map with such properties of a sigma limit set should have some kind of dynamical behavior on this set. For example, now in this case we have some analog of fixed point theorem. It's possible to construct a more complicated sets for which we have not only fixed point, but any number of fixed points, any finite number of fixed points. We can construct a space with this property, in which we necessarily should have some number of fixed points for any continuous map on this space. The problem is the following. Is it possible to obtain such a set for a continuous map for which we have this set of four sigma limit set for a point? The answer is following. If we consider space, for example, a grid space, then any nowhere dense compact set in this space can be a sigma limit set for a continuous map of the space contains itself. For example, such kind of set can be a sigma limit set in the plane. Another question is for
Porch Pirates of Cells. That is a subset of the space that P and S. Which are conditions under which this part pair of sets can be pair of omega Lebesgue set and sigma Lebesgue set for some point x, x from the space x. Such a situation where this pair of P and S are the pair, a pair of omega and sigma leading sets for a trajectory, then we necessarily have that P is not is an MMT set and P is either fine or better. Under additional condition that the point X is belongs to P. So we suppose here that we approach the omega limit set from inside. And the set S is as a non-empty or is equal to P or is lower than P. For the case of space X, interval, we can formulate the following statement. If P is equal to the whole space, no, P. Since in this case we have the P, the set P is perfect, we can have only three possibilities. This set can be only finite or a counter set or the whole interval. Or the set of intervals which maps each internal one in a cyclic way. But we consider in this theorem only these three cases. If P is finite, then it is necessary that sigma limit set is equal to omega limit set. This is the simple case. The second is more interesting. When P is a counter set. And in this case, one can find a continuous map and point X from P such that omega limit set is equal to P and the sigma limit set is equal to set if and only if is either S is equal to P or S is lower than C. This is for the case of interval. And for if P is equal to the whole interval, we have the same condition is a pair of P and S can be sigma omega sigma pair for a point from P from the space in this case. If either S is equal to P or S is lower than S. So we can see that there is many cases can be realized for continuous maps with the interval. And in the general case of Euclid space, we can any non-Euclidean set, closed non-Euclidean set can be sigma limit set. And we see that sigma, there are a lot of sigma limit sets for continuous maps. For the basins of sigma attractors, similar to the basins of omega attractors, we can obtain similar estimates. In general case, we have a general estimate for sigma attractors in compact matrix space. This set should be an F sigma delta set. And this was proved in my work, but it's not clear where this estimate for basins of attractors can be reached. And the example for some suggestions that this can be reached is the following. If you consider the 10th in the case of the homocrine trajectory, for this case we have an omega attractor, which is this homocrine trajectory. But for the basin of omega attraction of this set. It was proved by Professor Sharkovsky that the set of category. And the estimate for this set for omega attraction is H. But for sigma attraction of the point zero, fixed point, we have the following inclusion. Any trajectory for which we have sigma omega attraction is equal to the homocrine trajectory should be included in the basin of the sigma attraction of the point zero, because any omega limit set which has this form should have a sigma limit set is equal to zero from the main properties of sigma limit set. So it's true that such kind of estimate is reached. This is for the resolution. This is for the description of this situation. Another kind of objects which are connected with the sigma attractors are invariant measures. If we
time is expired, so we'll use a couple of minutes to reach the end point.
Yes. We can consider in such way as a sigma set, we can consider basins of invariant measures. And these invariant measures define basins of mu as follows. This is a limit of Chesar means for measures of which are concentrated on the trajectory. For this basins of invariant measures, we have a similar
estimates, upper estimates, we can prove that the set B of mu is the FC concept, and the set T is the points which are controlled the measure, but only limit points of the system. And for this set T of mu, we have an upper estimate is much easier. And we have also some estimates which can prove that this basin in general is not the set of is massive set from the category point of view. Usually, in a typical case, it's the set of first category. Despite of the fact that this set is a set of a full measure, it's no contradiction between rows of category and measure.
Questions? Short question, please. Not long.
Okay. Andrei, do you apply your theory to the study of concrete dynamical systems, like Lorentz-like system? Can you distinguish, for example, your sigma limit sets in such system or something like that? Exactly. Применяете ли вы в вашей исследования конкретные
динамические?
Вот если, например, такие вот сигма-периодические множества в системе Лоренц.
I don't know about Lorentz system, but we usually use to this objects to understand one-dimensional examples. Okay. For example, for such kind of this is a problem. For example, if the set is a sigma level.
So I also ask for short answer, not only for short question.
Okay. No. The answer is no, yeah?
No.
You don't know.
I don't know about the Lorentz system.
Okay.
And such kind of study.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, let us thank the speaker again.